Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back to the channel. My name's Oliver Shillitoe, and if you're new around here, I deal in gear reviews, plugins, mix tips, all that kind of thing. So sit back, welcome. Today, we're having a look at something that has been a game changer for a lot of producers, mixing engineers, and even mastering engineers. We're looking at the Kush Audio Clariphonic, which is a parallel equalizer, purely focused in high-end and high-end enhancement. It's designed to add clarity, air, and depth to your mixes or to individual sources in a way that's almost kind of magical and definitely not as harsh as you might get from a traditional EQ boost. So what exactly is the secret sauce? How does this unit work? Well, it takes the incoming signal and it splits it into two, and then it processes one and it leaves the other one untouched. Now, what it's doing to the other one, it's targeting specific frequencies. So rather than broad stroke high-end boosts, it's targeting specific areas to lift up different, shall we say, flavors from the dish. And it does it in a way that's very, very musical sounding. So you could say this is a bit of a boutique item, but Kush Audio also make a plugin version of this. And we're going to run the plugin through its paces as well and see how it stacks up against the hardware to see if the hardware is worth you parting with your hard-earned cash. Let's take a look at the hardware first of all. All right, so looking at the Kush Clariphonics, I have a pair of 500 series modules here today, but they do also make it in a 19 inch, which is a single rack unit version. They both do exactly the same thing, just different form factors. Your top dial here is silk and shimmer. Now, silk is like pure air. It sort of rises all the way up to 30 kilohertz and above. Shimmer is what you might describe as electricity, maybe, which is like 18k and up. Then you've got sheen and presence. Now, sheen is like old-fashioned treble, like good old CLA treble, so like 8k and up. Presence is like bite and cutting sound, which is 4k and up. So that's your clarity. So you can select which bands are affected here, and this is the amount. Looking at the bottom of the unit, the focus section packs a tremendous amount of power into a small number of controls. You've got two options here, open and lift. Open, well, if we start at the bottom, lift is kind of the lowest this equalizer is going to touch. It's around 800 hertz and up. And then your next band up is upper mids, which is around 3k. And then, of course, you have a dial to dial in the amount that you want. It really is that simple, to be honest. There's not much else to it. Now, for the eagle-eyed viewers among you, you may realize that, yes, I am lay on the floor. I just thought I'd try something a little fancier, but the back racks are quite short. So anyway, one thing I've found in practice with this EQ is it's very, very easy to overdo it. Very easy to overdo it because the result's just so pleasing. You can dial it in more and more and more, and it just sounds better and better until you come back the following day and realize that you've absolutely shit the bed and it sounds just way too harsh. So the one thing I would urge is caution. Dial it in to where you think it sounds great and back it off, because that's probably somewhere closer to the actual sweet spot that you want. Anyway, let's have a look at some audio examples. All right, so we've got the Clariphonic plugin up on screen. I'm just going to play through the verse of this song.
Yeah.
the subtleness of that air band. So, almost full on silk. Let's try the plug-in. I definitely prefer what the hardware's doing there. It seems to bring the vocal out a little bit more. Tell you what, the plugin's really close though, in terms of its overall sonic character. All right, let's see what it can do on vocals.
Eyes on the skin, I trace them with my lips on the sink, lean back.
Definitely a big old volume boost. All right, let's dial in the plugin the same and see what we got. Alright, so just a couple of quick examples of what you can kind of do with the Clariphonic. I mean, there's only so much high-end I can boost. Before you start saying in the comments, yes, the hardware was a little louder. But I think overall, I think the plugin's really, really, really close. I found that especially in the vocal example, the vocals seem to be pulled out a little bit more, especially the background, the harmonies, they seem to mesh a little more. So whether or not the hardware is doing some saturation or anything like that, it may be, which is contributing to the overall effect. But the plugin, again, is very, very close. So my advice would be this. If you're looking to get into the world of parallel high-end boosting and you're running a bit of a tight budget, the plugin's going to suit you absolutely fine. It's close enough and it sounds really nice. If you've got a little bit of cash to burn, then sure, grab a hardware unit because you can't go wrong. Hardware always sounds amazing. This is probably one of the first videos that I've done that I can think of where I would say that the plugin is like 95% on the hardware. You can get away with not needing that hardware sound if you're going to do something like a high-end boost. Because like I said earlier on, you've got to go easy with this thing. So if you overcook it, it's not going to sound bad, but it'll be overly present, shall we say, without sounding harsh. The EQ, you can push it full tilt and it doesn't fall apart. It sounds amazing, but tastefully, dial it back a little bit. Anyway, thanks for tuning in once more. And if you haven't yet subscribed to the channel, which like 90% of you haven't, please consider doing so. It really supports me and it is free. Enough of the begging. Until next time, take it easy and be well.